Hey friends, we're gonna continue with this winter theme that we've got, and it's perfect because we're gonna be writing our names in Snowflake. I know, isn't that great? So simply it looks like this, and when we open it up, all the way, little more, if I can get a hold. Isn't that great? We're writing our names in Snowflake. Hope your name's not Jennifer or something long. So anyway, let me show you how I did it. So I'm gonna put this one together real quick and give you a little walkthrough. All right, so if you have 11 by 11 copy paper, that works really great. I just had this doodle pad, art pad paper. So it's 12 inches, so by 18, I believe. And I'm just gonna fold over to make a square. So gotta square it up first and go ahead and cut off, just follow along that line. And whenever you're showing the boys and girls how to do this, then just kind of let them follow along with you. Show them step by step and then they can do it. And you can do it too, get out a piece of paper and try it with me. So now I have a square. Let me move this out of the way so you can see the dark of the table now. All right, so I'm gonna fold it in half to cut it. And then I'm gonna fold it in half again. All right, good. And then fold it in half once more until it's about like this. And you've got the exact size of your snowflake of what you're gonna do. So you can see already by doing a regular, using a regular piece of a copy paper, 8.5 by 11, it's gonna be really small because this already got smaller. You're gonna also now take the paper and make kind of an arc so that you can round off the edge, which means we're gonna trim off a good portion of this. What I did was I just kind of looked across and thought, okay, that's about it. So I can make an arc basically like this. All right, then I can simply cut that. And if it needs to be trimmed, needs to be trimmed, so it's not exactly the way I want. So I'm gonna trim it up a little bit until I get it more like what I want. And so any of these would work just fine. You know, the great thing about this is that your lesson can be that just as God doesn't make every snowflake alike, they're all different, He doesn't make us alike either. We're all different as well. So if you want to round this up even more, you can do that. That's totally your choice, the artist's preference. The next thing you want to do is you want to write your name. And I'm thinking in bubble letters or big fat letters somehow, so that way you've got enough of your snowflake to actually show up. You might try different things. Let me add the K to this, and always, when you're making these bubble letters, you do want them to touch. So that way, the pieces are all connected. So you could do big N's and little ones, your choice. All right, so that's kind of a funny K. And then begin cutting out each of these letters until you've gotten all of the negative space removed so that you can open it up and reveal your snowflake. All right, I want to show you one little trick that might help, and that is when you get to the R or the A in my name and you have an inside cut, go ahead and cut all the way up on the inside of it, and then you can cut out the space in the top of the R. Of course, I think it doesn't need mentioning, you noticed already I did all capital letters. That helped a lot. But just that one side, and then you can trim up the rest. So I think you get the idea about cutting it out and making sure you've got all of that spaces. Be sure you don't overcut in any way. It's because you don't want to lose part of your snowflake at all. Okay, so then when you finish cutting it, then begin opening it up and see what your name looks like in Snowflake. It's really pretty cool. and every child's name will be different. And you can display them on a beautiful bulletin board, and I think it would be really, really fun. So you try to make your name in Snowflake and help the boys and girls be able to do the same. I think it'll be a lot of fun. Just thank them. Thank God that He gives us snow, and that helps to water the earth even in the winter. Okay. I want you to also know we have great ideas on classroom swag, and it's 20 pages every month. It's like a digital magazine that you can send to all of your workers, that you can print off and give to them, and I promise they will not be disappointed, because this is filled with great ideas. There's like two ideas on every page for your preschoolers, for your children. There's games, bulletin boards, things for parents as well, and you're set to go. Just print it and pass it out. Go to getclassroomswag.com and you can see all of that and get a free copy today.